CompTIA ITF Plus Complete Training Course. Exam Objective 2.3, explain the purpose of common internal computing components. Cooling. Heat is a natural byproduct of electronic operations. As such, efficient cooling methods are needed to prevent damage and maintain safe operating temperatures. Within a computing device, you are likely to find one or more of the following three cooling methods in use. First up, we have a heatsink. A heatsink is a metal structure that absorbs and disperses heat generated by electronic components, such as CPUs or GPUs. It helps prevent overheating by providing a larger surface area for heat dissipation into the surrounding air through the process of convection. Heatsinks are a passive cooling device capable of minimal heat dispersion, but they can be combined with cooling fans in order to increase their efficiency. Oftentimes, computing devices output too much heat for a passive heatsink to handle, so a more common cooling method is to utilize fans. Fans are considered active cooling and improve heat dissipation by increasing the airflow across computing components. The general logic is more fans will equal more cooling. But there will be a limit. If fans still come up short and things are getting hotter, there is one more option. You can use liquid cooling. Liquid cooling offers superior cooling but comes with a higher price tag. This type of cooling would be best suited for a high-end gaming PC. In a PC, liquid cooling involves actively circulating a liquid, typically water or a coolant, through a closed-loop system. This method provides the best cooling because liquids are more efficient than air convection at dispersing heat. In summation, heatsinks are good, fans are better, and liquid is best, unless cost is an issue. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more great content.